Hi, welcome to my channel. In our previous video, we saw that how we can put different types of validation on our entity's attributes and how we can show the custom message by handling the exception thrown by the validator through our controller advice class, which is global exception handler. Now, some of you may think that how we exactly know that which method we need to override in order to handle the exception. And today we are going to see that. And also we will see that how we can handle and customize the date formats in Spring Boot. So let's get started. When we submit the data of employee to this endpoint, Spring will pass this object of employee to validator because we have annotated this particular parameter with @valid_annotation. And if the validation fails, the validator is going to throw an exception, and any exception thrown within the scope of the controllers is going to be handled by this controller advice class, right? Any other exception thrown by the piece of code which is not inside the scope of the controller is not going to be handled by this class. Let me show you an example. Just remove this valid annotation from here and put it here inside the employee service class. Okay. Kill the terminal and submit this, and we will see that this time the output is completely different. See? Because this exception is not handled by this controller advice. Okay? And of course, we can create custom classes to handle exceptions thrown by any piece of code in our project. But that we will see in future video. But for now, let's stick with the agenda of this video. Let's undo what we have done. Remove this from here, put it back here. And let's detach this controller advice from the context. Kill this terminal, run it again. I want Spring to throw that old bad request message. Okay, 400 bad request. Now, go back to the console and check what exactly caused this exception. Okay, see? Method argument not valid exception. So this is how we know that which particular handler we need to override. So in our case, we overrided this particular method. Method argument not valid. Okay. But there is a problem here. This method handle only exception, which is resolved as method argument not valid exception. So what about other kind of exception? Let me show you one example. Kill the terminal. Now uncomment this annotation, save it, run it again, and this time let's submit invalid date. Okay, hit send and we are getting nothing. Okay, but the status is 400. So what exactly is going on? Go back to console and we cannot see any kind of error here because we are not handling the type of exception which has been thrown by the program. So how we can handle that? Let's comment back this line again, save it, kill the terminal and run it again. Now send it again. Okay, bad request. Now come back here and let's see what has been resolved as exception, which is HTTP message not readable exception. So we exactly know that what kind of exception we need to handle. So let's do that. Handle message not readable, right? Now remove this. Let's create a response body. Say map of string and object body equal to new hash map, then body dot put error ex dot get message, right? And then return new response entity say body, headers, and status. Now uncomment this and save it, run it again, hit send, and this time we are getting the exact message, right? Now you can also handle the type of exception which do not have any predefined method that you can override. For example, if you are coming from my previous video, you know that I have also created one exception handler method inside the controller itself to handle the request param validation, right? Now, since we have created the controller advice to handle the exception thrown by the controller, you can actually move this function from here to here. Right? Now save this and kill the terminal, run it again. And this time we are going to hit this endpoint with ID 0, because here we have the validation that the minimum value should be 1. Okay? So this exception should be handled by this function. Let's see. Okay, employee ID should be greater than 0. This is the message that we exactly want to send back to the user, right? So this is the end of the exception part of this video. Let's see how we can customize date formats in Spring Boot. There are two ways that you can use to define the parsing rule of date formats. One, you can directly apply that rule on the attribute itself. Okay. The another way is you can define the global rule in your Spring Boot application class. So let's see both of them one by one. With our current configuration, we can save the date and time in this format only with time zone. Okay. If we try to save the time like in this way, it is going to fail. Let me show you. Send this, and here you can see the message like this format cannot be passed as this. Okay, so if you want to save this record, you need to pass the time with time zone. Okay. However, if you want to save the date only without the time, it will accept that, right? So date time with the time zone is suitable if you are planning to host your application all over the world or in different countries. Okay. Now let's assume our application is limited to only one country and we want to persist the date and time in this particular format. Let's say YYYY and then MM, then DD. Let's say HH, MM, then SS. Okay. Let's first see the rules on attributes level. How we can force Spring to accept date and time in this format. Go to employee.java and on joining date, add annotation temporal type.date. Okay, and then annotate it with JSON format, then pattern, let's say YYYY, MM, DD, HH, then MM, then SS. Save it. Let's create one more request here. Post, localhost add employee, body, raw, then JSON format. And here, and time is 15:30. Send it. Okay, so now this format is acceptable. Now let's see what we get if the record insertion is successful. Let's provide the valid inputs. Click send. Okay, joining date. We are getting the date in required format, right? Now let's see how we can do the same thing using the second approach, which is defining the parsing rule in our Spring Boot application class. For that, first let's create two variables here. Let's say date format equal to, okay, and let's say one more, date time format. Okay, now let's define a bean, public Jackson to object mapper builder customizer JSON customizer, then return the builder dot simple date format is going to be our date format, and then builder dot serializer new local date serializer date time formatter dot off pattern, let's say date format. Okay, now copy this and define the rule for local date time as well. Okay, this time instead of date format this will be date time format. Okay, semicolon at the end, save it. Now remove this pattern from here, run the application. Now hit send again. Okay, since we have defined the simple date format for date type, so now on our response is going to be in this format. Okay, now let's see how we can handle the zone date time. We have one attribute here in employee.java which is left on type of zone date time. So let's see how we can handle this. First, let's pass the left on here, and since it is a zone date time, so we need to provide the zone with the time. Let's say 25, time is say 15:30 plus 05:30. Okay, send it. Okay, oh, we need to start the server. So let's send this. Okay, left on is 20:21:4:25:10 a.m. Whereas we have passed 15:30 of zone 5:30. So how we can resolve this? It is returning the default zone. Okay, you can configure your Spring Boot application limited to a specific zone. To do that, go to your properties file, and here specify the time zone spring.jackson.time/zone, okay, equal to asia/Kolkata. Okay, save this, kill the terminal, run it again. Now hit send, and this time we are getting the expected time. Okay, now we can format the response as well. We haven't specified the rule for zone date time format. So let's do that. Copy this, paste it here, and let's say zoned date time serializer, and let it be date time format. Okay, now save this, run it again. Now hit send, and this time we will see date time in our required format. So this is how we can customize our datetime format in Spring Boot. So this is it for this video. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye bye and take care.